station on Space to Ground.
Nothing like a surprise spacewalk. Welcome to Space to Ground. I'm Dan Hewitt. Peggy Whitson and Jack Fisher returned to the vacuum of space for a little repair work on Tuesday. The pair went outside to replace a computer relay box called an external MDM that failed over the weekend. Peggy worked to remove the old MDM and swap in a new one she'd built up and tested. Meanwhile, Jack crawled around the Destiny lab to install two new wireless communication antennas that will improve signal on future spacewalks. They were finished in only 2 hours and 41 minutes, which was long enough to bump Peggy up to third on the all-time spacewalking list. Thomas Pesquet found himself in a strange position this week for the benefit of space science. The GRASP experiment is trying to get a handle on the role gravity plays with the human nervous system and how we adapt to living in space. Using virtual reality and motion tracking, Thomas reached out for virtual objects, giving researchers a better idea of how important gravity is compared to other senses when trying to interact or pick things up in space. This could be hugely helpful in training astronauts for spacewalks, as well as giving a better understanding of hand-eye coordination in general for us on Earth. When he's not fixing up the orbiting laboratory or performing cutting-edge science, Jack Fisher is taking space desserts to a whole new level. Jack showed off his most recent creation, the bite-sized mountain of yummiosity, complete with instructions on how to enjoy. He and Thomas Pesquet also broke out some pudding for a spectacular zero-G snack. I've said it before, but if you aren't following Jack's awesome mission of awesomeness on Twitter, at Astro2Fish, you really need to. Keep sending your questions using the hashtag Space2Ground. We'll see you next week.
Subscribe for more space.